Welcome to my new YouTube channel, Sky Aviators. Hello everybody, today we are going to start part 2 of chapter number 5, Semiconductor Physics. Let's discuss today's topic. There are total 4 topics: intrinsic semiconductor, extrinsic semiconductor, n-type semiconductor, and last one, p-type semiconductor. Let's start with first topic, intrinsic semiconductor. Before starting intrinsic semiconductor, I request you all, please like, share, subscribe to my channel. Do watch my previous video on semiconductor physics part 1. Now let's start. A semiconductor is an extremely pure form is known as intrinsic semiconductor. A semiconductor which do not have any impurity is classified as intrinsic semiconductor. Under the influence of electric field, a conduction through semiconductor is by both free electrons and holes. Its conductivity is poor as compared to extrinsic semiconductor. As we studied earlier, we know that conduction through semiconductor takes place by both free electrons and holes, and the conductivity of intrinsic semiconductor is poor as compared to extrinsic semiconductor. The total current inside a semiconductor is the sum of the current due to free electrons and hole. Hence, number of electrons is equal to number of holes. At room temperature, intrinsic semiconductor has a very few free electrons and holes. But at absolute temperature, an intrinsic semiconductor has no holes or free electrons. Hence, it acts as an insulator. In this diagram, the conduction through an intrinsic semiconductor is shown by free electrons and holes. Now, second topic, that is extrinsic semiconductor. By adding a small amount of suitable impurity to a semiconductor, it is then called an impurity semiconductor or extrinsic semiconductor. When we add an impurity to a semiconductor, it is classified as an extrinsic semiconductor. Now, the process of adding an impurity to a semiconductor is known as doping. Here is the definition of doping is given. When we add some impurity to a semiconductor, the process is called as doping. Each atom of donor impurity is electrically neutral. When we add some impurity to a semiconductor, this impurity is electrically neutral, which carry no current. Generally, for 10 raised to 8 atoms of semiconductor, one impurity atom is added. Depending upon the type of impurity added, extrinsic semiconductors are classified into two types, that is n-type semiconductor and p-type semiconductor respectively. Let's start with n-type semiconductor. When a small amount of pentavalent impurity is added to a pure semiconductor, it is known as n-type semiconductor. As a name pentavalent says, penta means 5 and valent means valence electron. The atom which having a 5 valence electrons is called as pentavalent atom. So when a pentavalent impurity is added to a pure semiconductor, a n-type semiconductor is formed. The addition of pentavalent impurity provides a large number of free electrons in the semiconductor crystal. Let's see the example of pentavalent impurity. Arsenic and antimony are pentavalent impurity. Such a impurity which produces a n-type semiconductor are known as donor impurity because they donate or provide a free electrons to the semiconductor crystal. So the pentavalent impurity provides a large number of free electrons, the electrons which they donate. Hence they are called as donor impurity. Let's see the example. Arsenic having atomic number 33. electronic configuration of arsenic is, first orbit there is 2 electrons, second orbit there is 8 electrons, in third orbit there is 18 electrons, and last orbit, that is valence orbit, there is a 5 valence electron. Hence arsenic is a pentavalent element. When a small amount of pentavalent impurity like arsenic is added to a germanium crystal, a large number of free electrons become available in the crystal. Let's see the diagram. In this diagram you can see a pentavalent impurity, that is arsenic, is added to a germanium atom. Arsenic form 4 covalent bond to neighboring germanium atom. But the 5th valence electron of arsenic atom finds no place in a covalent bond and thus remains free. As you can see, the 5th valence electron of arsenic forms a no place to form a covalent bond with germanium and hence remain free. Therefore, for each arsenic atom added, one free electron will be available in the germanium crystal. So each arsenic atom provides a one free electron, yet an extremely small amount of arsenic impurity provides enough amount to supply millions of free electrons, which means a small amount of arsenic impurity added in a semiconductor crystal can supply a millions of free electrons in an atom. The addition of pentavalent impurity has produced a number of conduction band electrons, that is free electrons. Many new free electrons are produced by the addition of pentavalent impurity. The thermal energy of room temperature still generates a few electron hole pair. However, the number of free electrons provided by pentavalent impurity far exceeds the number of holes. This is due to predominance of electrons over holes. That is called N-type semiconductor, where N stands for negative. In this diagram you can see very small amount of holes are created in the valence band, but there are large number of free electrons in conduction band are present. Let's see the N-type conductivity. The current conduction in an N-type semiconductor is predominantly by a free electron, that is negative charge, and is called N-type or electron type conductivity. As we know that the current conduction in N-type semiconductor is mostly by an electron. In this diagram you can see a large number of electrons are present which carry an electric current in a N-type semiconductor. Now last topic, that is P-type semiconductor. When a small amount of trivalent impurity is added to a pure semiconductor, then it is called as P-type semiconductor. Now trivalent. Tri means 3, valence electrons. The atom which having 3 valence electrons is called as trivalent. So in this, a trivalent impurity atom is added to a semiconductor. The addition of trivalent impurity provides a large number of holes in the semiconductor. Example of trivalent impurities: gallium and indium. Now such a impurities which produces P-type semiconductor are known as acceptor impurities, because the holes are created and can accept the electron. In a P-type semiconductor, a trivalent impurity is added which create a large number of holes compared to electrons, and we know that holes have a strong affinity towards electron to accept the electron. Hence it is called as acceptor impurities. Now let's see an example. Gallium having atomic number 31. Electronic configuration of gallium is, in first orbit there is 2 electrons, in second orbit there is 8 electrons, in third orbit there is 18 electron, and the last, that is valence orbit, there is 3 valence electron. Hence gallium is a trivalent element. When a small amount of trivalent impurity like gallium is added to a germanium crystal, there exists a large number of holes in the crystal. Here we can see a trivalent impurity atom, that is gallium, is added to a germanium crystal. Each atom of gallium fits into the germanium crystal, but now only 3 covalent bonds can be formed. In figure you can see, gallium can form only 3 covalent bond with the germanium atom. But in the 4th covalent bond, only germanium atom contributes 1 valence electron, hence 4th bond is incomplete. Being short of 1 electron, this missing electron is called hole. As you can see, there is a 4th valence electron of germanium is present, but as gallium has only 3 valence electrons, only 3 covalent bonds are formed, and hence here a hole is created. Therefore, For each gallium atom added, one hole is created. The small amount of gallium provides a millions of hole. The addition of trivalent impurity has produced a large number of holes. Therefore, a few conduction band electrons due to thermal energy associated with the room temperature. But the holes far outnumber the conduction band electrons. It is due to predominance of hole over the free electrons, that is called p-type semiconductor, where p stands for positive. Means in a p-type semiconductor, a large number of holes are created than electrons. So predominance of holes is greater than free electrons. This is the definition of p-type semiconductor. Now in this figure you can see a large number of holes are created in the valence band, but there are very few electrons present in the conduction band. Now p-type conductivity. The current conduction in a p-type semiconductor is predominantly by holes, that is positive charge, and it's called a p-type or hole type conductivity, as we know that hole carries a positive charge. So in p-type conductor, the current conduction is mostly by the holes, and thus holes carries current, and this is called as p-type conductivity. Now first let's see which material we are taken, that is n-type material and p-type material. So keep in mind, both the n-type material and p-type materials are electrically neutral. Both n-type materials and p-type materials are electrically neutral majority carriers, as we know that in n-type material large number of free electrons are produced. So majority carrier for n-type material is by free electrons. And now in p-type material a large number of holes are created. So majority carrier for p-type material is by holes. Now minority carriers. Very few holes are created in n-type material as compared to electrons. So minority carrier for n-type material are holes. And in p-type material very few electrons are produced as compared to holes. So minority carrier for p-type material is by free electron. Let's see the diagram. In this diagram you can see majority carriers are electrons, minority carriers are hole for n-type material, and we know that n-type material are also called as donor impurities. Now here for p-type, majority carriers are hole, minority carriers are electrons, and they are also known as acceptor impurity. This is all about the today's topic. Thank you for watching the video. Keep supporting the channel. Please like the video. If you find any query, please comment, and don't forget to subscribe the channel. Again, the notes are given in the description. I will take your leave by saying the motto of my channel. Let's study together. Let's grow together. Thank you.